As I left my old college campus the other day, I got to thinking about the last time I'd made this drive in March of 2020, before I really knew who John Lewis was and before pandemic had reshaped the everyday lexicon of American English. I was there to judge at a speech tournament. At the time, we all thought COVID would hit a few people that weren't us and then fade off into memory, like we were immune because of the democracy we weren't sure we could hold on to. Joe Biden was the "you're late to the game, man, step off" presidential candidate no one quite believed in but our parents. White people weren't wearing Black Lives Matter shirts because George Floyd hadn't been murdered for 8 minutes and 46 seconds on national television yet. And I was sitting in my Prius with this existential struggle of wanting Bernie Sanders to be the president, but not wanting to join the team of volunteers working to make that happen, of wanting to do something for racial justice and the environment, but too afraid to leave the screened-in box of a YouTube video on some kid's phone screen in Canada, or the Facebook posts my friends of color would love and provide me with serotonin while Bolsonaro burned the rainforest, as black as the futures of minority kids in defunded school districts. So many of us were unhappy, but too afraid to speak to anyone that disagreed with us. And then at some point we jumped from hashtagging activism on social media to cold calling strangers, begging them to vote for a man some of us had spent months trash talking to our parents. By the spring of the first year of the new decade we'd really been too excited about, a nuclear centrifuge had opened up and was swallowing America, slowly but surely enriching a weary populace into a force to be reckoned with. By May, the streets were filled with black bodies not yet killed by police and determined never to be. By August, John Lewis had died and high school kids were being suspended for filming the lack of masks in their school hallways and calling it good trouble. By September, with the loss of the notorious RBG, Americans were realizing, as these gods of our culture died mortal, that they had only ever been as human as us, but with more awareness of the power that brings. Hashtag 2020 sucks, tagged to the end of an Instagram post, was, by November, the 16-year-old not yet able to vote, but running a voting precinct in Atlanta. It was the Republican man marching alongside his children for racial justice, and it was the thank you card and flowers sent from relative strangers to the woman in a nursing home, phone banking from the hospital bed she was quarantined to. 2020 guilted us into being good people, and as bone-crushingly exhausting as the year was, activism in isolation and masked in the streets of America as our leader knelt on the neck of the nation, it also feels now like a bizarrely disguised blessing. By the time I was making this drive again, it had taught us how to be our own heroes.